Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. Okay, so we're going to begin our first project. So I'm going to hit play on this project and we're going to listen to it and watch it all the way through. This is what we're going to be making for the first part of this course. Icon animations, all sorts of amazing infographic type things. Let's give it a watch. And at the end, we'll hit stop and we'll go off and create our new document and get started. The value of sleep for creatives. Now, there is an ongoing debate in our household about the value of sleep. My wife, a solid 8 hour a night lady, is forever reminding me, using finger quotes there, to get more sleep. I, on the other hand, am certain all I need to perform at my best is just 5 to 6 hours. So as long as I'm in bed by 1 a.m, I am good to go by 6:30. Now my problem is that I love to work in the quiet of the night, where the whole world is asleep and nobody can get me. More finger quotes. For me, there's something about that slight hint of exhaustion, fueled by a bit of caffeine, that makes me excited and creative at that time of the night. So what is it about sleep deprivation or insomnia that appears to aid my creativity? Okay, simple enough, but some cool techniques we're going to learn in here. So let's now jump in and make our first document. Okay, so we've opened up After Effects. Now it's time to create our first file. They call them projects. Okay. And inside of these projects, we have something called a composition, or referred to as comps. So the project doesn't really do anything. Click new project and you just get this kind of like blank window. So think of projects as just like an empty placeholder. The comps that you put inside of it are, think of them as like pages in a document. Okay. You can have a document without any pages. It's not very helpful. So a project is not very much without any comps. So we're going to create our first comp. You'd think you'd go to file, new, nope. Under composition, new composition. Okay, so there's two ways of creating a comp. You go composition, new composition, like we are here. You give your comp a name. So this is going to be my first comp. Okay, and in here, there's a lot of settings, but pretty much all you need to do is go down to this presets and pick HDTV 1080 25. That's going to be HD resolution at 25 frames per second. That does most of the world most of the time. Occasionally, if you need to go to TV and you're in the US, okay, you got to use 29.97. It doesn't really matter, especially if you're going out to, say, social media, YouTube, Vimeo, your website. It doesn't matter. Are these two here the negligible differences? You could also pick 24, but nobody picks that, so just pick this one here. Okay, HDTV 1080. 1080 is the pixel height of your video, okay? And the width is, you can see here, 920. But when somebody says 1080p, they mean the height of the video. 720p is standard definition, and that is the pixel height of the video we're making. 4K, okay, down here. You could be working in 4K if you've got the footage for it. The only problem at the moment with 4K is the file sizes are quite big. YouTube accepts it, so you might do it. Okay, there's no problem with that, but it gets pretty hard on your system when we start animating things. I've got a pretty good MacBook Pro. It's only a few months old, and I got all the optional extras, and working in 4K just kills it. So I don't work in 4K because it's just too hard now, and people watching it, I don't know who's going to see my web animation infographics on a 4K monitor. Anyway. Square pixels, perfect, frame rate, don't change. This resolution, okay, stick it up to full. All that means is that this can change occasionally, okay, so you're gonna export a video and it's gonna export at quarter quality. Okay, it's like turning the resolution way down. We want the quality to be at full. And then the duration, okay, it's up to you. I think the default, I can't remember, it's 10 seconds, I think. And this is how many frames. Okay, so 10 seconds is the second lot here. That's the one you need to remember. So how long is this going to be? It's hard at the beginning, especially if you're not working to say some live action. Live action is going to have a start and an end, so you know how long it is. But if you're working in your own kind of time, you're like, how long should this thing be? Take a guess. Okay, it's easy to shorten it up to extend it. So we're going to start with 10 seconds. Background color here, I wouldn't change it here because if it doesn't really matter what you change the color to when you export it, it's going to be black. Weird, huh? So if I go like this and say, actually, I'm going to use one of these colors over here, you think that the background color is going to be, yes, red. Okay, but when it renders, it goes out black. That's just kind of like a placeholder color. You actually have to draw a big red box in the background for that to actually export. Cool, so now we could start working. The other way to create a comp, and this happens a lot, especially if you've got footage you're working to. In my case, we're working to a pre-existing MP3, okay, with some dialogue on it that we're gonna be animating our infographics to. So it's a set piece, it's a certain amount of seconds long, okay, so we could open the MP3, work out how long it is and try and match the comp, but there's an easier way. So I'm gonna bin this thing here, okay, and what I'm gonna do in my project window here, this is where all my files go for my project, anything that we import, videos, sound effects, shapes from Illustrator, anything goes in here. So we're gonna go to File Import, go to Files. Now if you haven't already, download the exercise files, okay, mine are here on my desktop. We looked at how to download those in the previous video. Go check that out. Okay, so in here, I'm going to go into it. Our first project is going to be this one called Icon Pop. Open them up. Okay, and we're working to this Value of Sleep MP3. Okay, so I'm going to bring that in. We're going to use that. And because that has a certain time, it's 29 seconds and 7 frames long. So what we can do is just right-click it and say Make Comp from Selection. Okay, the cool thing about it is that it's matched my 1080p. You can kind of see it's small up the top here. The right frame rate, but it's matched the length of it perfect because there's no need for it to be any longer. So the big things when you are getting started, if you are good at After Effects, you can skip through the next video, but we're just gonna look at little things here. That's the MP3 we brought through, and now magically, this is the comp. It's used the same name as this. So what we're gonna do is just rename it just to say, we're gonna add comp to the end. We'll do this while we're learning, okay? Just so they know where that's a composition. The reason we know it's a composition is mainly because of this icon here. See this little film reel with some bits on it? Okay, that is the comp, and these are the important things. These are the things that we'll export at the end. They're the pages in my document. Remember, project is this overall empty space. These are the things that you need. You need at least one. You can have multiple pages, okay? Lots of different animations, lots of separate animated infographics or data visualizations in here, okay? But we're just gonna have one for the moment, okay? Your comp appears down here in the timeline, okay? There it is, Value of Sleep comp, and it's automatically put my MP3 on the timeline. So there's my little playhead, okay? I can drag that back and forth, my CTI. Okay, if I hit spacebar on my keyboard, it's me talking to myself. Okay, so that's the MP3 playing, and that's gonna be along the bottom there, just doing its thing. We're gonna lock it, see this little locking icon here? And you'll notice that these little tags in here, I added these when I was first putting together these project photos. I did these with something called markers, and we'll look at them later on, but it's just gonna help us know when these infographics are meant to appear. Now, one thing we'll do just before we move on is that everyone go up to Window, go to Workspace, and click on Default, and then go back into there, Workspace, and then go to Reset Default, just to get everything looking the same as me. If you do find during the class, you end up dragging that over there, and that becomes there, and it's all mixed up, just go back to Window, Workspace, still on Default, we're gonna Reset Default, go back. It's a good way to get yourself unlost. All right, let's go to the next video. Hey there, what'd you think? If you liked the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable, printable PDF cheat sheet, okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.